Hi everybody, and welcome to this tutorial where I want to talk to you about starting with a watercolor paint. And if you are a drawer like me and you wanted to start practicing your watercolor techniques, then it is very wise to start with watercolor pencils. So it's not so big a deal anymore. And you can see I'm using the Van Gogh watercolor pencils. This is the lady that we're going to draw and paint in this case. And I will start out with the brown one, a very neutral color that's smartest to do. You can see I've also put in a little picture of the lady with some little helper lines, and the paint is by Rembrandt. Furthermore, I'm going to draw and paint on the Arches 300 grams 100% cotton paper. And I love that paper, it's very nice. And you can see I've put in very thin the two little helper lines. And then I simply start out with, trying to figure out where the top of the head will be and the bottom of the head, the chin. So I point these out first, and what I'm noticing is that the hair that's flowing all the way down to the left corner of the bottom of the page. So that's a very nice line to hang on, to cling on to. And you can see that the hair is flowing over the bowl, which is the head. And with that brown watercolor pencil, I simply start to make landmarks if you want. So I know where the eye is going to be, where the nose is going to be, etc., etc. So I'm simply start drawing like I would if I was to draw a charcoal drawing, for instance. So the nice part about heading out with the watercolor pencils is that if you make a mistake, you can still erase it, and you can correct little mistakes, so you're not thrown into the deep with just a pencil that you start out with brushes. That would be very hard if you're only used to drawing with pencils or charcoal or something like that. Now you can also see the little helper lines, and you can see how easily they are erased, so I make sure that they are gone before I proceed later on with adding water. Well, the eye is very important, and also the distance here to that big front bone, the frau, if you want. And I'm pointing out where the eyebrow is going over that heavy bone, and place in the second eye. I'm also starting to point out where shadows are going to be. You can see it here on the back of the head. There is shadow in the hair. There's also a spot of dark here on top. So I also point these out with the pigments from my watercolor pencil. And the string of hair is important, that it's flowing over the front of the head, and then the hair is going all the way down. And I think that's a very nice gesture, a nice way of the way the head is tilted. And on my Patreon page, I do a full tutorial, so all in real time for 2 hours, where you can draw along with me and paint, of course, should you be interested. So check out my Patreon page and you can support me here. And you can also find the prints so that you can start to draw and paint along with me. All in brown here. I've also pointed out the beautiful flowers that are on her dress. And for the darkest colors, I also used a little bit of purple. And then it's time for action. I'm using a round brush, number 12. So that's quite a big brush. And I start with adding water to the pigments that are placed on the paper with the color pencil, watercolor pencil. And well, this is where the fun begins. And as you can see, the model is all in black and white. So now I have that freedom to create any color that I want. But first, let me show you. This is the brown and the purple pencil that I used. And here you can see that purple pencil. I used it for the darkest areas. And then I also go into the face with the water. And I want to see what the pigments from the pencils will bring me. And I think they are floating around really, really nice. And it's great to see how the pigments are behaving themselves. And here with the eye, I try to be as delicate as possible. I'm still using that number 12 brush here. This is where the pupil is going to be, and I'll just add some water and then let it rest for a while. So if you're happy with a sudden with an area, then you want to leave it alone, let it dry, and then later on you can work it further. Now that I have all the pigments into the paper, I will shift to my actual paint, and the paint is by Rembrandt. And I first add a layer of water around the model. So I made sure that the model was dried up and then, and only then, I place in the layer of water. And I am mixing here the Pinus Gray, a little bit of sap green, and the blue together. And now I can start creating a surrounding around our model. Then I make sure that that surrounding is dried up again. And then I can work further on with the hair, for instance. So make sure that the areas that are joining together, that they are not both wet, because when they are both wet, then they will blend together. Now here behind the face, there's a very dark area, which is from the inside of the hair, if you want. So I'm putting in my first layer here with the paint. And of course, there's also a string of shadow underneath the jawline and the chin. So I put that in too. And then again, I just let that dry and see if I can get away with it. Now, on the left side of the face, there is also a lot of shadow. So I'm simply using that same mixture of the Pinus Gray, the blue, and the green to start creating shadows in the face itself. I also want to put in a shadow on the right side of the face. Now this can be very scary. It's blue with the pinus gray. And I simply put it in. If I think it's too dark, I can always put in more water or pick it up with a tissue or something. But also note that once the paint dries, it always dries up a little bit lighter than what it is when it's still wet. So don't be too much afraid. Now here I'm picking up, and you can see how beautiful the hairs in my brush make a very sharp point. And here I'm going in for the second layer in that eye. Just let it rest there a little bit. This is where the ear is going to be and the shadow on the back of the head. And I check if the background is dried up enough, yes, already. And then, and only then, I put in the shadow inside the hair. So, I hope that makes sense. Then I put in a third layer here for the inside of the hair, just behind the face. And I want to make that quite dark. I want that contrast so that the face will pop out even more. So I'll just put that in and just see what that brings once it's dried up. So yeah, it is a bit daring, but you will learn a lot by showing some heart, if you want. And well, I think that's nice. And of course, the watercolor is it sometimes has a mind of its own, but it is also a plus, I think, because for me it's very tempting to work with those pigments and see what they bring me. You can see here I put on a little bit of mascara on the eye. The left eye can use a little bit more detail too. I will do that later. I want the most of the attention to go to the right eye and less to the left eye. So I continued, and I think she looks a little bit pale. She looks nice, but she looks pale. And I want to add a little bit of imaginary colors. So I'll simply put a little bit of blue in the flowers. See what that brings to the face. But I think the face is not warming up by putting in the more cold colors. So I think I will have to put in some color into the face itself. Sometimes when you alter something in the surroundings, that does something with the face. But I'm going to use a little bit of yellow ochre and mix this with the red. And it's a simple cadmium red with yellow ochre. And this is a little bit daring too, but I simply put in a layer of this mixture into the face. And as you can see, that instantly brings in the light. It instantly brings in a little bit of skin color. And I'll try to make it as smooth as possible because she's very young. And here on top of the head, I can use a little bit more. You can see it, and then I ease it down to make it as soft as possible. No hard edges here. And I can just get away with it. So it's daring, I know it's daring, but it sure works. The face now looks a lot rounder. and well, maybe put this hair a little bit way to the back. You can see that the they are blending together now because it wasn't dry yet, but I think it's quite a nice effect. So that's how surprising the watercolor can be. I love it. Well, at the end the painting was dried up and I removed the tape that was around it. And all I have to do now is put in my name. I can put it inside the watercolor painting, or I can put it just outside. If I was to frame it, then I can use a passepartout, which is a little bit bigger, to show the beautiful pigments of the watercolor. So, this is our combination of the watercolor pencils and the watercolor paint. And isn't it amazing? I loved making this sketch here with you. It's a sketchy painting, but I sure love it. Well, of course I hope to see you in my next tutorial. Or maybe I can meet you on my Patreon page. But for now, I would say thank you for watching and take care.